for a minute, provided the application may go over the time to recognize that.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, thank you, members of the committee. 2007. In 2015, I filed a Medicaid disclosure. One reason, I started seeing the influence that these Medicaid entities had up here, and it became, if you look out over the last few years, we had an $8 billion DHS appropriation due, which is most of that, if not all of Medicaid. So that is the one single largest, block of money that we appropriate. So I filed a bill in 2015 that passed the Senate, got sent to House Rules, which kind of confused me why I got sent to House Rules instead of State AC's. But it was maybe a little too restrictive. So I knew that that bill was going to fail, and so didn't pursue it. Then we started having situations come out that I believe is the dirty little secrets of what's been going on in the Arkansas legislature. Money going into the personal pockets of the legislators outside of what can be explained to somebody that is in the medical community. And every time those bills have failed, there's been three bills in three different committees that have failed, and each time after that, we continue to see headlines, unfortunately, where Medicaid entities are being named or involved in. Had legislators, Steve Jones, for example, most recently Mike Neal, and that could possibly be back to the Medicaid. He's already did this problem. So you have these situations where you find out these legislators have been receiving money, personal money, not campaign money, personal money. And I just feel like, folks, that should be disclosed. And like I said, each time it gets failed, well, then we find out later why it's failed. We vote on an $8 billion appropriation bill. And if the pro tem has a consulting company, whatever that is, you know, they should be. I mean, if a Medicaid entity want to come out and park on by a $50,000 cap, they can do that. And on my SFI,